the hypopressive series 1. First thing, make sure that your bladder is empty. Every time when you're going to do hypopressives, it's very important that your bladder is empty. Second, that you didn't just eat, that you ate at least 2 hours ago. Okay, that's number two. Third, if you have high blood pressure, just focus on doing the postures. Don't do the breathing, because hypopressive increase the pressure, so you don't want that. Second, if you are pregnant and you are on the third trimester, don't do the breathing. Why? Because you can speed up the contractions and the baby can come sooner, and you don't want that. Third, if you have hypothyroidism, I hope I pronounce it right, related with the thyroid, please just do the postures, not the breathing. Why? Because the body's already using the sympathetic system during hypopressive. And what is that? It's the system that keeps us alert. And a person with thyroid problems is going to have, is already using that system. So just the postures, okay? And now, what I want you to tell you is the breathing. The breathing is very important, but the most important part is the recovery. So every time that you do the breathing, I want you to take a moment to recover. Why? Because hypopressive, if you don't recover, you're going to compromise your immune system. So what is going to happen? Your immune system is going to get weaker. So that is why it's so important when you do hypopressive to have a good instructor to do it right, so you don't compromise your immune system. So let's go there. So when you do the breathing, when you do apnea, you're going to do the apnea and then you inhale and then you exhale 3 times. You're going to do it this way. I'm going to demonstrate. So I'm going to go straight to the apnea. So you do exhale, apnea. Inhale, and check what happened. What you're going to do, exhale, the third one, again, inhale, exhale, again, inhale, exhale. What I mean with this one, you're going to, after the apnea, you're going to inhale once, exhale, and when you exhale, the third one, you're going to exhale for 6 seconds, very slow and relaxed. Why? Because you are using the sympathetic system, that is the one that keeps us all alert and moving. And also, when you do for 6 seconds exhalation, you activate the parasympathetic system to keep you calm, to relax you. 6 seconds. What I do in my practice, I do the sound, I do because it feels good, feel like relief. Okay, now are you ready? So let's do this together. Today you're going to learn 3 exercises, 3 hypopressive postures. Very important, do every other day because the body needs time to recover, and I will tell you later why. Are you ready? So you're going to have a very good posture. A good way to have a good posture is practice at home this. Just to hold this and walk with a book on your head. Why? Because this is going to help you to have the perfect alignment. So you don't have to think too much, what is the perfect alignment? The perfect alignment means that you feel like someone is pulling you from here and is making you taller. So during hypopressive, we use the postural muscles. So that is very important to have a very good posture. So first, you're going to separate your feet. They are going to be the distance apart with the hips. Can you see me there? Okay. And then you're going to micro bend your knees. Then you're going to bring the center of gravity. What I mean with that? You're going to bring the weight of your body forward toward your toes. Why? Because every time when you do this, when you go forward, when you go like this, you are activating the pelvic floor muscles. And we need that, okay? So, Let's keep going up, okay? Then, what you're going to do, you're going to bring those shoulders down. You know, make sure that they're being pulled down. That's also help you with posture. Then, look at what happened with your hands. You're going to bring the hands up. Then do a double chin. When you do double chin, check what happened to my tummy. Go straight, right? If it's for you too hard to do a double chin, what is that? Remember, imagine that someone is pulling you up. Just try to do it, okay? Ready? Dun, dun, dun. Now, the position is like that. Then you're going to bring the weight over your toes. Move your arms to 45 degrees. 90 degrees. Rotate your arms all the way down. And then put your fingers at the side of your hips. This is position number one. Don't forget, you are putting weight on your toes. And you can feel it even just for the people that are pregnant, we have high blood pressure, even just doing this, you are activating that pelvic floor muscle, making that pelvic floor muscle stronger. So it feels good. And then let's do this. So you're going to do a normal breathing 3 times and then we do the abdomen. This is something that I forgot to tell you. At the beginning, you're going to hold the abdomen for 5 seconds. The goal is 25 seconds. It's because you are stretching a lot of muscles inside. So 25 seconds is the time that we need for the, I'm not going to use that word, for the muscles to get the message to the brain to get stretched. Okay, ready? Let's do it. Inhale, expand your tummy, exhale. Inhale, bring the tummy out, exhale. One more time, inhale, expand the tummy, exhale, and apnea. Inhale, exhale. Again, inhale to recover. Exhale 3 times. And until 6 seconds. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Okay. Probably you're going to ask me how I do the apnea. Okay. If for you, you're new to hypopressive, it's going to be very hard to understand. So imagine that you are in the ocean, in a pool, and you want to go under the water to dive. So you are going to inhale. You went to the water, right? You are with no oxygen in your lungs. So you are all on the water and you are holding it, right? But you exhale everything first. So, and then you are going to try to breathe. That is one way to remember. The other one is that you have a drink and you have a cherry on the bottom and you have the straw and you want to try to get that straw to fit through the, I'm sorry, the cherry to fit through the straw. So you're going to do the same. Like at the same, the air doesn't come out. A good way to get trained about that is when you exhale everything, you cover your mouth and nose. So let's practice. Inhale. Inhale through the tummy. Exhale. And then try to breathe, covering your mouth and nose. And you just keep practicing that, okay? Don't forget the breathing. Okay, let's go again 2 more times with this position. Microbend your knees. Pull the shoulders down. Double chin. Hands up. Hands at 45 degrees. Hands at 90 degrees. Rotate your hands. Put your hands by the waist. Inhale to the belly. Exhale. Weight on the toes, remember. Inhale, expand the tummy. Exhale. Inhale, expand the tummy one more time. Empty the lungs. Apnea. Inhale, exhale. Okay, inhale, exhale. 6 seconds. Again, inhale. Six seconds always. Inhale. Another thing about longer exhalation, at the end of exhalation, you're activating your abdominal muscles, so it's very good. Again, let's do it. The same. Microbend your knees. Bring the center of gravity of your weight forward. Now, palms up. Double chin. Make yourself taller. Hands at 90 degrees. 90 degrees was here. Now hands on these bones that we have here. And inhale deep. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Apnea. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. One more time, inhale, exhale. Like I said, I love to do the because we're relaxing. Now let's go with the position number two. Another thing during hypopressive, you're going to say, when I'm going to gaze horizontal. You know, because that's also involved in our postural reactions, in our muscles, okay? Okay, now, the same position, you know. So 45 degrees, 90 degrees. This time, your hands are going to go here, below the belly button. Can you see? Here is where the hands are going to go. Now, look what is going to happen. You're going to bring your elbows forward. You see, I tend to bring this shoulder up, so make sure that your shoulders are down too. So let me show you. I have been doing this for a while, so I can rotate my arms all the way this way. I don't expect that you do it right away. But you're going to feel a stretch here, but please, no pain, it's just a stretch. So this is the way that's going to look. Bring the elbows forward, center of gravity toward your toes. And from here, you are going to do the breathing. So inhale, expand your tummy, look at that, exhale. Don't forget the double chin and weight on your toes. Inhale, exhale. One more time, inhale, exhale, apnea. Inhale, one, oh, again, inhale, exhale, again, inhale, recover, Okay, let's do it again. So while we're doing three times, so our brain learns with repetition. Okay, the same thing. This is basic. This, what we're doing right now, is basic. Applies to all the standing postures, the position of your hands. Remember, bring it below your belly button. Activate that pelvic floor muscle, bringing your weight over your toes. Make yourself taller and make a double chin. Okay, I will go so this way. Bring those elbows forward and keep the shoulders down. Okay, can you see? I'm going to go closer so you can see what's going on. Okay, right there. Okay, so gaze forward, double chin. Inhale, expand your tummy. Exhale, empty the lungs. Inhale, expand your tummy. Exhale, empty the lungs. One more time. Inhale, expand your tummy. Exhale, empty the lungs. Apnea, and open your rib cage. Inhale, exhale. Again, inhale, exhale. Again, inhale, exhale. One more time, inhale, exhale. Okay. Remember, at the beginning, you are not going to be able to hold the abdomen for a long time. It's okay, it's with practice that you can do it, and depend how do you get up in the morning. You know, sometimes we get up kind of in a, we have to do this and this and this, so our heart rate is up. So that also make that apnea, the lung capacity to decrease. Okay, ready? Let's do this again. I'm going to go closer so everybody can see me, okay? So you already know the position of the legs, right? The position of the legs has to be the same distance with the hips. Like that, right? The same distance. And then, microbend those knees. Make yourself taller. Someone is pulling you from here. Shoulders down. Arms at 45 degrees. Arms at 90 degrees. Rotate your hands until your hands are touching these bones. Slowly bring those hands below the belly button. And I go closer so you can see. Inhale, expand the tummy. Exhale. Inhale, expand the tummy. Exhale. One more time, inhale, expand the tummy, exhale. Don't forget the elbows forward, I was forgetting that. So, elbows forward, apnea. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Okay, these are the three exercises that you will bring home. So number one, let's review. I'm going to go just fast, so you can take notes, you can write it down, because this is your homework to start doing it, not tomorrow, the next day. So you can start seeing that your waistline start getting smaller, the abdomen get flat. Okay, so number one, I'm going to go just fast. Actually, I forgot, this is number two, number three. Oops. The number three is going to be this one. So you go to 90 degrees and check what is going to happen. During the apnea, you're going to do this. Okay? And you will see when you bring the arms up during the apnea, you will feel how the pelvic floor muscle has room to relax, and you will feel how the transverse abdominis contract. Okay, let's do this. Arms at 45 degrees. Arms at 90 degrees. Rotate your hands and put it below the belly button. Make yourself taller, double chin. Inhale. Gaze or horizontal. Exhale. Inhale, expand your tummy. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Abdomen. Arms up. Inhale, one, again inhale, exhale, ha, 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 inhale, exhale, ha, 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 one more time, inhale, exhale, go to position in initial position, center of gravity forward, hands up, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, below belly button, make yourself taller, feel how your back elongates when you do that, okay? Inhale, expand your tummy, exhale, inhale, expand your tummy, exhale, one more time, inhale, expand your tummy, exhale. Abdomen. Inhale. Exhale. To recover, longer exhalation. Inhale. Exhale, ha, ha, ha. One more time, inhale. Exhale, recover, ha, ha, ha. Let's do it again. Microbend your knees, shoulders down, palms up. Make yourself taller. Bring the weight over your toes to activate that pelvic floor. Hands at 45 degrees. Oh, excuse me. Hands at 90 degrees. Sorry, I don't. Now, put your hands below your belly button. Inhale. Abdomen expand. Exhale. Empty your lungs. Inhale. Gaze forward. Remember, exhale. Inhale one more time. Exhale. And now let's do apnea. If you're not shy to make that sound is very relaxing. I do it because it feels great, and I am yoga instructor also, besides being a physical therapist, a doctor of physical therapy, so that I learn that really relax my clients and my patients. Inhale, exhale, and one more time, inhale, exhale. Now we have the three. One, two, Three to take home. So another thing, I know when people come to learn hypopressive, it could be because there are some therapeutic reasons and there are some fitness reasons. So I will tell you something. If you are in the fitness or also for health, you want just to feel better for your well-being, and you want to have a small waist, you want to have a flat tummy, so hypopressive will help you to reduce, to shrink your waistline by two sizes. Hypopressive is going to help you to flat your tummy. It's going to make your pelvic floor stronger. It's going to make your back stronger. But just hypopressive, the hypopressive needs a friend here, needs a healthy diet. And I'm going to tell you something. When we want six packs, you say, but why someone has six packs? There is a big factor, the amount of body fat. To be able to have six packs, you need, if you are a man, to have less than 20% of body fat in your body. And if you are a woman, you need less than 15% to be able to see those six packs. So in order to be able to have the best results during hypopressive is to combine with a healthy lifestyle. Put a lot of vegetables in that recipes, you know, in your food. Put a lot of fruits, a lot of things that are growing right now, seasonal, you know, because why? Veggies are low in calories, and also they fulfill you. Eat a lot of seeds, a lot of nuts. You know, I eat plant-based, but just I'm giving you an advice, you know, it's up to you. This is, you know, I'm sharing my lifestyle with you because this is what worked for me and for my clients. So that would be the best combination. So now let's talk about hypopressive. How many times should I be doing hypopressive? So you're going to do it just every other day for the first 6 weeks because you are learning something new. And we have here in the brain a little place that is called the amygdala, in Spanish, amygdala. And right there, we store our emotions, our memories. So in order for that amygdala to empty the information and receive new information, we need to sleep, and that will help you to let the bad habits or whatever that is there out and bring the hypopressive in your life. Okay, so very important. Every other day, empty stomach, bladder empty. In the morning, because hypopressive activates the sympathetic system, that means that you're going to be all alert, like when you go to work out, you know? So do it in the morning, the best, because if you do it at night, you will have more energy. Or if you want to go to stay longer at night, do it at night. And also drink a lot of water, a lot of, you know, electrolytes in your water, because when we do hypopressive, we tend to also feel thirsty. So make sure to do that. And enjoy this amazing gift that I'm giving to you. You know, it's something that really is a blessing to be able to be here giving this to you to learn. I know during this, it's hard times, right? But this is the moment to share with you. And please take it home. Do every other day. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also Instagram. And please also, I will see you next Thursday. Next Thursday, we're going to focus on tone your muscle from inside out, okay? It's going to be three more classes during August on Thursday. So I will see you at 9 a.m. California time here. And please write all the questions, all the doubts, all the comments. I'm here to guide you to succeed with this beautiful method that is going to help you to make those pelvic floor muscles stronger, to prevent incontinence. It's going to help you to correct the asta recti. It's going to restore your core after surgeries, you know, or if you have a weak abdominal muscles, it's going to retrain those muscles to stay with good contraction. It's going to release all the tension that the organs are putting on the pelvic floor and put it back in place. It's going to help you to have a beautiful posture. It's going to prevent back pain. It's going to prevent hernias. It's going to make you feel energized. If you have swollen legs, it's going to help you to decrease swollen legs. This is something that also is very important. It's going to improve your sexual life. Okay, this is something that I will talk with you later. So because it's really, really helped. You know, my clients are mentioning that life changing. Okay, my sweet people, so let's see who are here to say hello and be thankful for you. So, okay, I see Janet, thank you so much for being here. Elizabeth, Vicky, thank you so much for being here. And see you next week. Thank you so much. I love you all. I see Polly. Polly, thank you so much. Thank you for all your support. And don't forget to do the homework and you will see the results. You are going to start seeing smaller waves, beautiful body, beautiful mind, feeling great, energized, happier. Okay, my sweet people, I love you all. And see you next week, okay? Ciao, ciao.